December the 15th, today's wisdom. Two major characteristics of the scorner. The scorner loveth not one that reproveth him, neither will he go unto the wise. Proverbs 15:12. In this verse, the wise edifies his audience about the attitude of the scorner. Are we wise or scorners? You'll never see written on someone's forehead, scorner. The scorner is someone who can show himself under soft, kind, livable appearances at first sight, but in the long run to reveal himself very difficult to put up with. Two things characterize the scorner. 1. His attitude towards reprimand. 2. His surroundings. To know if you belong to the scorner's set, you just have to examine your attitude facing reprimand and the people around you. 1. Either you receive reprimand with joy and you adjust accordingly. It will set you free and surround you with people who will feel free to tell you what they think about you or what you do without hearing anything. 2. Either you reject it strongly and you surround yourself only with people who think, see like you, and who will never dare to rebuke you on anything for fear of reprisals. Because of the abuses and frustrations wrongly handled during his existence, the scorner built a wall around him to protect himself from future intruders. Reprimand works in the life of the scorner's painful memories that confine and get him defensive. The scorner constantly gets defensive and lives in a chronic insecurity. By his diverse forms of ruses, he becomes an expert in manipulation and is able to bring his listeners to call white black and black white. For the scorner, reprimand means that we don't love him, that he is an incapable person, a good for nothing, an insignificant person, etc. The true enemy of the scorner is himself. The true problem of the scorner is ignorance about God and himself. Being deprived from love, the scorner does everything he can to compensate that effective deficit by working hard to be seen and approved by others. The value of the scorner is found in what he does, not in what he is. This implies that he will be inclined to love people for what they do instead of who they are. Jesus says, "Beware of the scribes," Luke 20:46a. The value of the scribes was in their position and authority rather than in God. They put the emphasis on their position and authority to enslave instead of serving. Jesus made this warning to his disciples to preserve them from shortcomings and abuses which could arise from their position and authority. Application: to use my position and authority to love and serve the neighbor and not to manipulate, abuse, or enslave him. Warning and promise: he that refuseth instruction despiseth his own soul, but he that heareth reproof getteth understanding. Proverbs 15:32. Let's pray together. Father, help me to accept reprimand. Give me strength and authority to serve, not to enslave. In Jesus' name, amen. Today's reading, Psalm 71 to 75, Proverbs 15, you are blessed.